anyone that's rowed knows the deal. Everything you do incorporates a great deal of sacrifice and pain on your part. No one enjoys getting up at 5 in the morning. No one enjoys reopening old blisters or calluses on your hands. It takes a certain kind of person to feel their lungs burning and know that there's still more to give. And until they physically cannot move, they have not given enough. If you're rowing, you're in pain. The two are inseparable.
Every day, someone's training with a niggle here or an ache there.
No one complains. No one asks for sympathy. You just get on with it because it's expected of you and you expect it of yourself. If you let pain defeat you, if you let it get in the way of your training, if you let it stop you in a race, you let your crew down, you let yourself down, you let your coach down, you waste a year of your training, you never let it get in the way. Whilst the public see rowing in its grandest form in regattas, what they don't see is the constant grind, day in, day out, every morning, every evening, all year round. Never has a rower's ability to push both themselves and their squad members been so apparent as in the 2K test. Rowers are forced into a painful environment every time they train. You don't have to embrace it, but if you want any success, you must learn to deal with it. You want to quit. It's perfectly natural. No one will want to put themselves through this, but the rower must learn to endure it. They must tell themselves to push on for one more stroke, one more meter, one more time. Pain is temporary, but quitting is something that will stain your career forever. You'll lose your respect of your team. You'll lose your place in the boat. All your training up till now will be for nothing. But most importantly, you'll have failed yourself. There's no easy way out. When faced with these circumstances, the rower will choose to endure levels of pain that others would crumble at. It's just part of the sport. It's just what they know. There must be a reason, a motive, a goal. Why would anybody want to do something so demanding, so ruthless, and so painful? To find out, we are several current DUBC members.
Oscar Richards, men's captain.
Teddy Praviti, second year.
Lloyd Seaman, second year.
Mimi Carlton, second year.
I've been rowing 7 years.
7 years.
7 years.
10 years.
During my time rowing, I've suffered various stress fractures to my back.
I've been out for a month with tendonitis.
I missed a year's training from compartment syndrome.
I've slipped a disc in my back.
Misery from the go. Torture. Passion.
My job is to make them hurt themselves. Their job is to hurt themselves.
Push yourself to the point of collapse and then push on more.
All the hard training throughout the whole year becomes worth it when you cross the line first.
Pain is almost unlimited when you're surging through your opposition.
There's no other sport in the world where you can see your opposition when you're beating them.
The thrill of winning outweighs a winter of pain and injury.
Success and winning is worth the pain.
I make sure nobody backs off, ever.
Ah!
in rowing, an environment has been created where for you to succeed, you must conform to the accepted levels of pain and injury. Whilst the rower must pay their dues through endless hours on the water, in the gym and on the ergs, the sensation of success is a feeling that provides the justification and motivation that they require. To outsiders, these demands may seem outlandish, but for a rower it is simply something they must endure. It has become apparent from the interviews that the decision to continue rowing is in fact relatively simple. Therefore, there is a common denominator amongst rowers. Success isn't something they just hope for, it isn't just wishful thinking, it's a requirement, a demand, a necessity. Whilst pain is viewed as a negative from the outside, there's not a single rower who would have it any other way.